गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर वेल। डियर पेरेंट्स, वी नीड योर सपोर्ट, काइंडली सबमिट योर वॉट फीस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर वॉचिंग क्लास 7 साइंस, चैप्टर नंबर 8, सॉइल, पार्ट 16। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट इज वेदरिंग? क्वेश्चन मार्क। डिस्क्राइब एनी टू टाइप्स ऑफ वेदरिंग। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज यू नो वेरी वेल दैट डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेदरिंग इज अ नेचुरल प्रोसेस ऑफ ब्रेकिंग डाउन ऑफ रॉक्स इंटू अ स्मॉलर पार्टिकल्स बाय द एक्शन ऑफ विंड, ए वॉटर, टेम्परेचर। डियर स्टूडेंट, टेम्परेचर चेंजेस एंड प्लांट एंड एनिमल। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टू टाइप ऑफ वेदरिंग इज फिजिकल वेदरिंग और द केमिकल वेदरिंग। डियर स्टूडेंट, केमिकल वेदरिंग इन्वॉल्व्स केमिकल रिएक्शन टेकिंग प्लेस बिटवीन द मटेरियल ऑफ रॉक्स एंड द रेन वॉटर। रेन वॉटर बिकम एसिडिक वेन इट डिजॉल्व एसिडिक गैस प्रेजेंट इन द एटमोसफियर सच एज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड। इट फॉल्स ऑन द ग्राउंड एज अ एसिड रेन। डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस रेन वॉटर केमिकली रिएक्ट विद द मिनरल्स इन द रॉक्स एंड ग्रेजुअली ब्रेक डाउन द रॉक्स इन टू अ पीसेज। सॉइल फॉर्म्ड बाय द केमिकल वेदरिंग इज देयर फॉर डिफरेंट इन केमिकल कंपोजिशन फ्रॉम द ओरिजिनल रॉक। नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू टॉक अबाउट टू physical weathering, then physical weathering involved the physical breakdown of rocks into a particles by the agents such as wind, water, or change in the temperature. It is also known as mechanical weathering as there is no change in chemical composition of the rock. Dear students, for the example, the surface of rocks are formed by the sunlight during the day and become cool at the night. This repeated warming and cooling causes unequal expansion and constriction of the rocks, due to which the cracks are formed over time. So dear students, eventually the rock is broken down into the fine particles. So, dear student, in this way you have to write the answer. Now come to the second, explain how soil is formed with label diagram. Dear students, the soil formation takes place in the three main steps. First step, dear students, parent rock get broken down into a smaller particles by the various agent, weathering agent. Second step, dear student, weathering continuously as a rock pieces are further weathered into a small particles. The remain of the dead particles and animals, plant and animals present in the soil are decomposed by the or microorganism to form humus. Humus makes the soil more fertile. Dear student, third stage, minerals and the salt form the weathered rock are dissolved by the rain water and the slowing added to the soil, making it more fertile. It supply plant with nutrients so that they can grow. Dear students, you can also label the diagram. I will show you. Dear students, can also draw the diagram which is given page number 113. Dear student, you have to also draw the diagram. So dear students, diagram A, B, C, figure 0.8, figure 8.4, 8.5 and 8.6. Dear students, you have to also draw the diagram. Dear students, your answer is start from the soil formation takes place in the three main stage. It is not mentioned. Question number 2, it's not mentioned in your planner. So you have to mention question number. That question number is not mentioned in your answer. Start from the a circle. So dear students, from this circle, answer 2 is started. So answer 2 is started from soil formation takes place in the three main steps. Your question number 2, as the number is not given in your planner, so correct it and write here question number answer number 2 here. That answer, your answer is start from the soil formation takes place in the three main steps, first step, second and third stage. So dear students, you can write. Now third, draw the label diagram of soil profile and explain various layer of the soil. Dear students, you have to draw the this diagram which is given page number, dear students, 114 and figure number 8.7, soil profile. You have to draw the diagram, dear students. And dear students, you have to also explain various layer of the soil. So dear student, the main horizon of the soil profiles are O horizon. This is the top layer of the soil. It is rich in the nutrients and contains some partially decomposed organic matter. A horizon, it is the uppermost layer of the soil. It and is also dear students, it is also called top soil. The layer is in dark in color, soft, porous and rich in the humus, and has a very fine and small soil particles. Humus makes the soil fertile. It is also improve the texture of the soil and allows water and air to move in and out of the soil easily. Therefore, the topmost soil support the growth of a plant, and it has a nutrients, air and water required. It is also a habitat of the many insect and the small animals. Now dear student, B horizon, this layer lays below the top soils, is called subsoil. It is harder and more compact and richer in the minerals than the top soil. Subsoil is also lighter in color, and it contained more sand and stone. Dear students, nutrients present in this layer can only be drawn by the plants having roots and long enough to reach this layer. This layer has a very little humus and it is not suitable for the growth of a plant. So dear student, B horizon is not suitable for the plant growth. Now dear student, C horizon. This layer lies below the subsoil. It is made up of the partially weathered rock with a lot of cracks and rocks fragments. Further weathering over times may convert this layer into a B. Dear student, A horizon. Therefore, this layer is also referred to as a parent material, as it represents its first stage in the formation of the soil. The roots of the plant do not penetrate this layer. R horizon, dear students, this is the lowest most layer of the soil profile. It is called bedrock. It is made up of the hard rocks and provide materials for the formation of C and B horizon. Bedrock is non-porous and does not allow the water to seep through it. Now dear student, come to the fourth question. What is the soil composed of? Question mark, dear student, soil is a complex in nature, and major components present in the soil are parent material, water and air, minerals, humus and the soil organism. Parent material, dear student, this consists of rock particles of different size made up of the gravel, sand, clay, slate, gravels. Dear students, these are small and porous stones or rock fragments. Sand, dear students, these are porous particles that are smaller than the gravels. Clay, these are very fine particles. Slate, dear students, these are the medium sized particles that are larger than the clay but smaller than the sand. Water, dear student, water is retained in the air space between the soil particles. The ability of the soil, dear students, ability of the soil is absorbed to retain water is called water holding capacity. Next, dear student, air, the space between the soil particles contain air. This air is used by the roots of the plants and soil and dewelling organism to stay alive. Mineral, dear student, the sand sand and clay particles consist of minerals such as silica, quartz, feldspar, mica and oxide of calcium, magnesium, potassium and the phosphorus. These minerals are derived from the parent rock and they are absorbed as a solution in the water by the roots of plants and used for the growth. Humus, dear students, humus is made up of the bad and decaying remain of the plants and animals. It is rich in nutrients and improve the fertility of the soil. It imposes the texture and water holding ability of the soil. It encourages the growth of a useful microorganism in the soil. Soil microorganisms decompose the organic matter into the humus. Bacteria, fungi are the some example. Some small animals such as millipedes and earthworm and the snail play dear students, they are playing a very important role in maintain the quality of the soil. Now come to the fifth question, dear student. What is the soil erosion question mark? Describe its causes and its effect. Dear student, the gradual removal of the fertile top soil by the action of running water and wind is called what? Soil erosion. Cause of soil erosion, dear student, first is deforestation. The large scale cutting down of a forest tree is called deforestation. Root of the trees hold the soil together and prevent it from the getting exposed to wind and running water. With the removal of the trees, soil becomes loose and gets eroded easily with the moving winds and running water. Dear students, next is overgrazing. Overgrazing, dear student, grazing of animals on the same land over again without allowing the plants to grow back, it is called overgrazing. Due to overgrazing, the grass and plants covering the soil vanish, expose the soil. This exposed the soil is easily carried away with the moving and wind and the running water. Next, dear students, improper farming methods such as not making proper so they are also be effect to the soil erosion. Dear students, proper embankments around the agricultural lands leads to the soil erosion, mainly in the hilly areas. Effect of soil erosion, dear students, these are the cause. Now we discuss to the effect. Desertification, once the unfertile soil, a fertile soil top to soil is lost by the erosion, very few plants survive and our land become desert like. The process by which vegetation and the soil are lost and land turns into a barren land or the desert is called desertification. It is very difficult, often impossible, to restore desertified land to the fertile stage. Loss of cultivable lands, dear students. Now, dear students, loss of cultivable lands as the fertile topsoil is lost as a result of the soil erosion. The plant cannot grow the remain soil, hence the soil size of the cultivable lands reduce. Increase in flood, dear students, also. Its effect, erosion causes the land to lose its ability to retain water. It's make the flooding more common. Effect of water body, dear students, also. Soil and that is eroded from the land get carried by rainwater run off into a river, streams and lakes and the other water body. So dear students, hope you understood these question of answer of these questions. Thank you, student. Stay home, be safe.